All right, welcome back to the second half of the show. I hope you all bought lots of raffle tickets and voted for your favorite contestant. And as you know, it's pageant season again, and we have the opportunity to welcome a lot of our visiting title holders. So let's meet them now.
Hi, I'm Alana Bruce. I'm Little Miss Texas Star 2014 and Little Miss South Lakes, LSP.
Hi everybody, I am Amanda Hickenbotham, Miss South Lakes Outstanding Teen.
My name is Desiree Murray, Miss South Lake 2015.
Hello, I'm Skylar Fawn, Miss Arlington's Outstanding Teen 2014.
Hi everyone, I'm Paige Hill, Miss Parksley's Outstanding Teen.
Hello everyone, I'm Miss Twin Rivers Outstanding Teen, Madison Hildreth.
Good evening everyone, I'm Miss Duncan Mills Outstanding Teen, Mackenzie Rutledge.
Give them another round of applause. Thank you, ladies, so much for being here tonight. Just like me, I'm very anxious to see who will be crowned, but we still have a little bit of competition to go, and talent has always been my very favorite part of the competition, and I believe our Miss contestants are ready to show us just how talented they are. So sit back and enjoy the second half of our show and the next phase of competition. From the Phantom of the Opera, Christine Daae is missing her father after his death and remembering his musical influence. Singing Wishing You Were Somehow Here Again, here is contestant number one, Nasat Praveen.
Bring the beat back!
bring out contestant number three, Kristen Newman, as she performs her own rendition of Hallelujah.
Thank you.
All right. Next up, we have Sarah McKimmy, contestant number 6, and she is making her way to the piano to perform Jared Radnick's rendition of Pirates of the Caribbean. It actually says Caribbea, but, you know, it's actually Caribbean. Let's give it up for all these guys moving the piano. You guys are awesome. You're so quick. Do you guys clean? I have a lot of stuff that needs to be moved around and cleaned. No? Okay. So now for real, let's give it up for Sarah McKimmy, contestant number 6, who is now making her way to the piano to perform Jared Radnick's rendition of Pirates of the Caribbean. Drive by. Man, that's a nice car. And that's how NASCAR got its name. It's really cheesy, but it's appropriate. And everyone would laugh, so it worked. All right, next up we have contestant number 7, Spencer Davis, who will be performing a contemporary ballet on point to Stomp.
Thank you.
3 more Miss contestants to go. So let's bring out contestant number 8, Christina Kwasin, who has been playing violin since the age of 10. Her teacher didn't fall asleep, luckily. She currently plays with the new Live Symphony Orchestra and has chosen to perform a selection from Meditation of Thais today. Hope that was right. Whenever you're in interview training, they always tell you, just be yourself, the judges just want to get to know you in those few minutes that they have with you. And so when my little sister Riley was preparing for Miss America's Outstanding Teen competition the year that she was Miss Texas Outstanding Teen, we told her, Riley, she can bark like a dog and it's ridiculously amazing. If she was here, I would definitely make her do it. She has solid 4, but really like 7 that she could do, but there's a couple that are just amazing. She's mastered them. And we said, the one thing you cannot do in your interview is bark. So she comes out, and guess what? The first thing she tells us is, I get to bark in my interview. We're like, awesome. But the good thing is, it obviously worked because she was third runner-up to Miss America's Outstanding Teen that year. We were really proud of her. So I guess the barking pays off, and the being yourself is really what the judges want to see. And with that, we have, in 90 seconds, playing approximately 1,000 notes of Bach's Toccata and Fugue in D minor, originally written for the organ. Let's welcome Brittany Tu, contestant number 9, as she performs one of the most recognizable and hauntingly beautiful pieces ever written.
Thank you.
any of you tweeters or Instagrammers, I just wanted to remind you to please use hashtag MPFO in all your posts so that we can go online and we can see what you posted from the pageant. Only say nice things. I always think about, would I want to read this about myself? And if the answer is no, then probably shouldn't post it. All right. An original 1967 single released by none other than American soul singer Aretha Franklin. Let's welcome our final Miss contestant in the talent portion of the competition, contestant number 10, Nicole Shaw, singing A Natural Woman.
Las Vegas, as well as volunteering with the Miss Illinois pageant.
Putting her teaching career on hold, she pursued her childhood dream to be on Broadway and trained for 14 years in classical vocals, theater, and dance at the American Musical and Dramatics Academy. Please welcome Melissa Grimaldi. Teresa McCarthy has worked in the hospitality industry for the last 20 years and is the customer service director for Quiltcraft Industries in Dallas. She was born and raised in Ennis, the home of Miss Frisco, Kendall Morris, who went on to capture the title of Miss Texas 2011. Teresa is married to Daniel, a native New Yorker, and has two grown children, Hillary and Jeremy, and is Mimi to three beautiful grandchildren, Hannah, Brady, and Liam. Please welcome Teresa McCarthy. Jill Bean is a graduate from East Texas State University with a degree in education. She is employed with the City of Dallas Park and Recreation Department as the Events and Reservations Manager. Starting dance at the age of 3, Jill has taught dance at several dance studios and is also a jazzercise instructor for 8 years. She has performed at several civic organizations and clubs, including the Senior Follies production. Jill had the pleasure of serving as director of the Miss Texas Senior America pageant for 2 years. Please welcome Jill Bean. Tony Gavinito started his professional dancing and teaching career for almost 10 years and is certified as a ballroom, Latin, swing, and country western dance instructor. After working with various studios, Tony became an instructor with the world-renowned Arthur Murray Dance Studios and took his dream to Dallas. Some of his dance and teaching opportunities include the Dallas Cowboy Gang halftime shows with the Dallas Cowboy Cheerleaders, the Grand Ole Opry, charity events for the Margarita Ball, and Prestonwood's famous Christmas show, just to name a few. Please welcome Tony Gavinito. And finally, Leslie Riccitelli is a global sales executive in the aviation industry. She is no stranger to pageants as a former contestant, placing second runner-up and winning overall talent in Miss Kansas Outstanding Teen Competition in 2004. Leslie is a professional vocalist and has released 3 albums, allowing her to travel across the world performing. She also has 16 years of experience in dance and has instructed from classical ballet to modern jazz, from ballroom dance to hip-hop, from fitness dance to fusion, and many more. She is married to her husband, Chris, and has 3 amazing dogs. Please welcome Leslie Riccitelli. Let's give all of our team judges a hand for volunteering their time today. Thank you, judges.
All right, thank you, Madison, and thank you, judges, again, for your time today. We so appreciate what you're doing here by giving up your Saturday to pick our winners, so thank you. All right, Miss Talent is done. All the judges have been introduced, so we are getting closer and closer to meeting our new title holders. The contestants are backstage getting ready for the next phase of competition, and we want to recognize 2 other volunteers who have the task of auditing our judges' scores. Today we have Jamie Frazier, who is with the Miss Texas organization, and she is serving as our official state judges coordinator, which is a very important role to make sure that all the rules are followed. And quite frankly, someone needs to do it, and Jamie is the girl for the job. So thank you to Jamie for being here, and also to our auditor. We really appreciate both of you taking time to be here today. So now, let's get back to the competition with the most elegant phase, and one of my personal favorites, the evening wear competition. Here, the judges are looking not just at the dress, but also at the contestants' sense of style, confidence, and overall poise. Starting with our teen contestants, who will also compete in the onstage question phase of competition during this portion. Please welcome to the stage, contestant number 1, Kira Powell.
All right. What is your definition of success?
My definition of success is achieving goals that you've set for yourself and just knowing that you did the best you can and you tried your hardest. Thank you.
Next, we have contestant number two, Blair Kelly.
We moved in with my grandparents, and they have taken care of me ever since. Thank you.
Contestant number three, Holly Morgan.
Let them know to be able to be confident and feel more great in their skin, then it's worth it. Thank you.
Contestant number four, Justice Thompson.
Number six.
Zant. What would you change?
I would definitely eliminate the R word because this word hurts, and my platform talks about spreading the word to ending the word. Even if this word's not directed at a person, it still hurts, and I would like to eliminate that word.
Contestant number 7, Bailey Hodgson.
Because it helps you contact people from the whole other side of the world. I think social media is a great thing and it should be used in schools.
Contestant number 8, Stephanie Wynn.
Where would you go and why?
I would want to go to Paris because I think it's such a beautiful place with such a great culture and so much history. Thank you.
Our final team contestant is Addison Jackson, contestant number 9.
What would it be?
I would invent a form of communication that could reach people of all kinds because I feel like I could impact people in a way that nobody has before.
And that concludes our teens in evening wear competition. So let's give them all a big round of applause. They look absolutely beautiful. I don't think teens are supposed to be that pretty. And now we're going to continue on with the evening wear competition for our Miss contestants. So help me welcome them back to the stage. And we will begin with contestant number 1, Nasat Praveen.
Like your chest of chemical, shimmers in the depths below. We are, we are.
have contestant number two, Carissa Peterson.
Christina Lawson.
concludes our Miss Contestants and the evening gown portion of competition. Weren't they lovely? They were so lovely. And now I believe that Brittany and Mallory are supposed to join me up on stage, or actually take over the stage, to give some thank yous and to say thanks to our sponsors.
We would like to take this time to thank our sponsor, Mental Management Systems and Heather Sumlin. Most of you here are familiar with their training, but for those who aren't, their system is a recognized mental training program taught not only to world and Olympic champions, but to U.S. Navy SEALs, PGA Tour players, Miss USA winners, and Miss America finalists as well. The mental preparation for competition that is learned through their program takes even the most seasoned in their skill to a new level of success. The training I received has really helped me, and I personally can't thank Heather enough for her assistance. If you would like to learn more about the Mental Management System, they are hosting an open house next weekend, and if you go to their website, mentalmanagement.com, you can get additional information.
We would also like to thank our friend and evening gown sponsor, Larissa Maida of Shimmer Boutique in Carrollton. Larissa, you truly know how to make a lady feel beautiful, and your assistance with our program has been invaluable. Thank you for all that you do for the Miss Plano Frisco organization. It means more than you will ever know. As you may have noticed, it takes a village to produce a show like this. We would like to take this time to thank all of the many volunteers who made this production possible. Petals A. Florist, Legacy Taylor, Popcorn Market, Doug Rice Fitness, Plucker's Chicken, Zoe's Kitchen, Starbucks, our judges' meal sponsor, Mi Casino. The list goes on, and you can see more in the program book. A big thank you for our backstage assistance from Terry, I'm sorry if I messed this up, Toligman, Norville Sykes, and the Plano West Senior High School Theater Technical Team. They've all been great.
Also, a big thank you to our NPFO family and friends for donating funds to this year's scholarship funds. Erlene Garvey, Mike Graham, in honor of Christine Tang, Erwin and Irene Tang, Gina and Mike Fuller, Jordan Johansson, Catherine Dunn, and to the many volunteers behind the scenes, such as our NPFO board, Bobby Scott, and the Richardson Organization. Scott Heflin, Sandy Gray, John Birdwell, Kelsey Sugg, and our donation friend from the great state of Texas.
And more thank yous are to all of y'all. So can we have some house lights, please? Ooh. Okay, we had, I guess, an auction or a raffle or a something out there with purses, yes? And the winner of number one is Celeste Lay. You can stand up, I guess. Stand up and sit down. Oh, over there. Okay, number two, Jackie Estes. Number five, Susan Schuler. And then dresses go to number six, Celeste Lay. And number seven, Korea Moore? Karen? Is that Karen? Oh, Karen. Karen Moore. I mean, her name's the kid. Never mind. Okay, so yay, congratulations. I think we're done now.
Okay, so now we are going to go backwards, and we are going to have Brittany come out and do her farewell.
Well, we're back out here, and we have another goodbye. And this time, we want to honor a young lady that came into our organization 1 year ago. And quite frankly, she really didn't know what she was getting into when she did this. She freely admits it. But, you know, she came here and she competed, she won on her first try, and then we took her to state and off she was. She sprained her ankle when she got there. I mean, everything that could happen felt like it was going wrong, but, you know, that didn't let her spirits get down. She went ahead and she participated and had all kinds of fun, and I think that Ricardo has a little bit more about her to say.
Yes, well, that didn't stop Brittany. She was like the other new contestants, and we have about, I would say, 85-90% of the girls that you see tonight are all brand new. So let's let them hear it back there. Come on, parents, friends. because I don't know if any of us could be out in heels and swimsuit in front of people judging us, so it takes a lot of guts, believe me. So she did very well, placed in the top 15 at Miss Texas' Outstanding Teen, and was also presented the overall teen talent, or overall GPA award. So not only was she beautiful, but she is smart, and she has a lot ahead of her future. The proof is in the pudding, and as they say, because the college acceptance letters are flowing in.
Yeah, and as she said earlier, she's got a couple of additional applications that have come in, but I heard that University of Alabama was pretty enticing. So you never know, she might be a future Miss Alabama that's gonna be on the stage vying for the crown of Miss America. I totally believe that she's capable, and we wish her all the best. We love her, we're gonna miss her. And so for the very last time, we welcome Brittany Stevens, Miss Plano's Outstanding Teen 2014.
Outstanding Teen has been one full of amazing memories that I will cherish forever. There are so many people who have made my first year as a contestant one to remember, but first and foremost, I have to give the glory to God. This year I've seen Him work in so many ways, and I'm forever grateful for the opportunities He has blessed me with. Cindy and Ricardo, I couldn't have asked for better directors to guide me through my first year of competition. To my voice teacher, Brian, you worked wonders with my voice, and I can't thank you enough. Madison, my middle sister twin, I've loved spending this crazy year with you and making crazy fun memories. Christine, thank you for being the best miss a first-year contestant could ask for. You have been there for me since before I started competing, and I am so grateful that I was able to be your last teen queen. Mallory, when I competed last year, I had no clue that I was about to make one of my very best friends. We have had the best year together, and I love you, my fellow MPFO team. Heather, with Mental Management, you were a lifesaver this year. Thanks for helping this crazy first-timer get to where I am today. Katrina, Sydney, and Carly, thanks for being the best friends a girl could ask for, from coming to countless events and doing last-minute dress shopping to helping me with crafty things and calming me down in super stress attacks. I love you guys. To the Miss Texas Board, David, Jan, Michael, Amy, and Valerie, I am forever grateful that y'all pushed me to compete this year. You are such a huge part of my journey in this organization, and I can't thank you enough. I love you guys. Courtney, thanks for being one of my biggest supporters, no matter where in the world you are. To my sisters, Ashley and Haley, thank you for crying for me at pageants when I can't. Seriously, I love you guys, and I'm so grateful for your support. Mom and Dad, I love you guys. Thank you for believing me and supporting me in this journey that I knew nothing about. Dad, thanks for always coming with me to appearances. The role of pageant dad really suits you. Mom, thank you for enduring numerous stressed out shopping trips to make sure I have the perfect wardrobe. To all the other MPFO volunteers, sponsors, my Miss Texas Outstanding Teen sisters, and all my supporters, thank you for making this year one I will never forget. I love you all, and for the last time, I am your Miss Plano's Outstanding Teen 2014, Brittany Stevens.
Okay, now this is a very special farewell. Now it is time for a final farewell to our Miss Frisco 2014, Madison Fuller. Madison was the second sister of the Fuller family to hold the title of Miss Frisco's Outstanding Teen and went on to win the title of Miss Texas's Outstanding Teen in 2010. She was our title holder this year before and has been with our organization for quite some time. Talking about a young girl growing in front of my eyes, Madison is just all that and beautiful. This year at State, she was an Alpha Preliminary Talent winner and was awarded third runner-up to Miss Texas for her first time, not a bad deal. We are sad to see her go, but know that she will be successful in her future endeavors. Please welcome, for the very last time, Madison Fuller, Miss Frisco, 2014.
To the rest of the NPFO family, Sean, Kayla, Cheryl, Kelsey, and Ron, there would be no NPFO without all of you. Thank you for your dedication to this remarkable organization. To Heather Sumlin, Megan Matthews, Zach Grimaldo, Larissa Maynard, and Doug Rice, thank you for your incredible sponsorships this year, as well as Will Henderson and Sandy Miller Gray for your dedication in helping make my interview the best it could be. A special thank you to Larkin Page, Catherine Dunn, Angelica Rodriguez, Cassidy and the Brown family, the Vaughns, the Alexanders, and the Melnicks for being such encouraging and loving friends throughout this journey. To my sweet princesses, Denim, Jillian, and Rachel, thank you for all the smiles, giggles, and hugs during Miss Texas. Brittany and Christine, we had so much fun this year. It was always a party when y'all were around, and I love you both and look forward to seeing what God has in store for both of you. Mallory. I'm slightly biased, but I, without a shadow of a doubt, have the best team this year. All three Fullers have officially held the title of Team Frisco, but I really do think that you did it best. I love you beyond words, and I'm so proud of you. Morgan, sharing Miss Texas State with you this summer was one of the greatest experiences of my life. You continue to inspire me daily, and I love you so much. Mom, you have sacrificed so much in order for all three of us to follow our dreams, and thank you will never be enough. Dad, congratulations, because if anyone deserves an award this year, it would be you, for somehow not only financially supporting three daughters competing in one pageant, but always being present at every performance, appearance, pageant, whatever it was, even if there was football on that night. To Mimi and Granddaddy, thank you for supporting all three of us and always being our biggest cheerleaders, as well as babysitting Aggie whenever we have late nights in Dallas training. And finally, to sweet Amy, sharing my platform of your legacy this year was a true honor, and I miss you so much. It has been an extraordinary year, and I cannot be more humbled and blessed by the people who have touched my life and made me a better person throughout this journey. I look forward to the future and what God has in store, but will always be forever in debt to the NPFO for what this organization has done for me. Four new girls' lives are about to change tonight, and I cannot wait to welcome them into this incredible family. I love you all.
She's tender-hearted, she's smart, she's kind, she's generous. She's done so well in her career, and this is the last year she was eligible, and I'm really pleased that she was considering us to be the title that she would have as the final. I mean, we didn't know if she would necessarily win, but thankfully she did win. She did compete with us in 2012, and she did very well. She was fourth runner-up. She went and became first runner-up last year, and she was first runner-up this year, and there were just numerous awards that she's won throughout her career. I mean, it's a testament to the system when someone can compete, and even though they may not reach that goal that they wanted, they still have reached so much more. And the grace and the beauty by which she has accomplished that, to me, is just amazing and is a testament that something I look after, and I thank her for the example. And it has been, a testament to me, for me to follow. So I just want to say that Christine has a lot in front of her. She's finishing her law school degree, and she's going to be very, very successful in her next endeavor. And it's with a sad heart, but with a happy heart too, because I know the time has come and God's going to bless her continually. So for the last time, I present to you Christine Tang, Miss Plano 2014.
And I give him all the glory for this experience. To my incredible family, Mom, Dad, and Carolyn, thank you for your steadfast love and support. Every prayer you've prayed, every encouraging note you've written, every hour you've spent helping me prep and train, thank you so much, and I'm more grateful to you than words can express. To the Ms. Plano Frisco Scholarship Organization and my directors, Cindy, Ricardo, and Sean, thank you so much for believing in me, investing in me, and for your support, guidance, and dedication to help me be the very best I can be. You have truly changed my life. Thank you also to the Miss White Settlement Organization and the Miss CFW Scholarship Organization for allowing me to be part of your family and for being such a special part of this journey and for the blessing of being your title holder over the years. Thank you to the Miss Texas Organization and all the board members and volunteers for your dedication and hard work and for helping me transform from a shy little girl into who I am today and for enough life lessons and beautiful memories to last a lifetime. To my dear friends, Tanya Johansson and Mike Graham, thank you for your countless hours investing me and helping me not only prep and train for Miss Texas, but also how to be a better person in life. I can never thank you enough or repay you for all the magnitude of what you've done for me, but I will try by striving to be Miss America to every person I meet for the rest of my life. To Heather Sumlin in Mental Management, my amazing life coach, mentor, and dear friend who's been there for me every step of the way over the years, teaching me precious life lessons that I'll carry with me forever. You've transformed me into more than I thought I could ever be. To my dear friends and sponsors, Larissa Maynor at Shimmer Boutique, thank you for all your hard work finding me the perfect evening gown and cocktails over the years and the perfect accessories to go along with it. You are incredible. Legacy Taylor, Nagua, you are a true fairy godmother with the magical abilities you have. Thank you for the blessed assurance of knowing that anything in your hands will always be transformed into something perfect and absolutely beautiful. Wrapped in Wellness and Doug Rice, thank you for helping me get into tip-top shape. I've always considered fitness to be my weakness, but because of you, you helped make overall prelim fitness and overall fitness possible. To my sister title holders, Brittany, Madison, and Mallory, I love you all so much. I'm so grateful and blessed we got to spend this year together. I've loved watching you grow and conquer your goals like the superwomen you are. And to my sweet, darling Lone Star princesses and their families, I love each of you so much. Thank you for coming along this journey with me and for making it so extra special and precious. Finally, to my prayer warriors, friends, mentors, and everyone who's believed, encouraged, and invested in me, thank you for being my village and surrounding me with prayers, strength, inspiration, and love.
While I've been gifted many valuable skills, life lessons, memories, and experiences through my time as a pageant girl, the greatest gift I've experienced is how God uses a level of pain and challenges to change us who we are and to make us better fit and able for the beautiful life He plans for us to live. After placing first runner-up at Miss Texas for the second year in a row, the following months have been spent on my knees asking God for open eyes and an open heart to become transformed into the woman and servant he called me to be. That calling didn't include Miss Texas, but it's okay. To surrender your life to Christ means that when you get knocked off your feet, you can still get back up, stronger, braver, and more resilient than before. And I'm so thankful for how my pageant experiences have better equipped me for my mission to serve God and change the world. And so, to little girls and young ladies dreaming of becoming Miss Texas or Miss America one day, compete to learn, not to win. Then you'll always have had a winner in July because you grew to be more than you were before. Compete to learn more about yourself, more about the world, and more about how you can change it for good. Let yourself grow and be stretched, but remain steadfast in who you are. Learn to look past a person's appearance, opinions, and behavior, and into their heart. Be kind, warm, loving, and gracious. Have thick skin, but a soft heart. Be brave. And so, to the new Miss Plano, to you I pass the torch. Carry it with grace, strength, and love. Thank you.
Miss Frisco this year, and the teens as well. So let's bring all of the contestants out of this time and have one final look.
Yeah, honey!
one, it works. All right, for the teens, the talent winner is contestant number 9, Addison Jackson. The first runner-up to the title of Miss Plano's Outstanding Teen is contestant number 1, Kira Powell. We are ready to crown our new Miss Plano Outstanding Teen. Ladies, are you ready?
Woo!
Yeah? Come on, that was pathetic. Ladies, are you ready?
Yeah.
That was way better. I know, they're teens. They can do all that high-pitched screaming. All right, without further ado, the new Miss Plano's Outstanding Teen is contestant number 9, Addison. To announce the first runner-up for the title of Miss Frisco's Outstanding Teen. And that is contestant number 8, Stephanie Wind. Addison, are you ready to have a sister?
Yes.
Bridesmaid?
Yes.
All right, let's get you one. The new Miss Frisco Outstanding Teen is contestant number 3, Holly Moore. We are going to now announce the winners of the drawing, the raffle, and People's Choice, but I need those results. So, let's, I have the results. Look at that, you ask and you receive, amazing. All right. The People's Choice tonight was Madison Jackson. This is the winner for $100, and it goes to 004054. And if that's not you, you can come punch her. Not me. Is that anybody? Because I'll totally take it. We have a winner. All right. Congratulations. $100 was Sandra Gray. She's a former Miss Texas, and she is actually going to give the money back to the organization. So let's give her a round of applause. That is so sweet. All right, teen contestants, could you girls scoot back, and can the Miss contestants step forward for me? Let's give it up for the Miss contestants. All right. For the Miss contestants, the lifestyle and fitness and swimwear winner goes to contestant number 6, Sarah McKimmy. The talent winner goes to contestant number 9, Brittany Chu. And first I'm going to announce the title of Miss Frisco. So first runner-up to the title is contestant number 5, Megan Falcon. Ladies, are you ready? All right, let's do it. Our new Miss Frisco is contestant number 6, Sarah McKimmy. Now for the Plano title. The first runner-up is contestant number 4, Devin Kearns. Yeah. to find out who our new Miss Plano is, and that is contestant number 9, Brittany Tu. Together, your first victory walk.
Got nothing.